Everyone, today we will talk about the metabolism of branch chain amino acid, that how these amino acids are metabolized. As you know, the branch chain amino acids are mainly three: LIV, the leucine, isoleucine, and valine. Now, first thing first, these amino acids are not metabolized in the liver. Unlike other amino acids, they are metabolized in the skeletal muscle. They are mostly metabolized in the skeletal muscle. Later in the lecture, we will also talk about the glucose-alanine cycle briefly, that how the metabolism of the branch chain amino acid led to the formation of alanine. Now, in the book, there is this description of the amino acid in the form of a diagram, and the whole three amino acids are described at a time, but I will describe them one by one. So, let's first talk about leucine. The first step in the metabolism of the leucine, just like all other branch chain amino acid and most of the other amino acid, is the transamination reaction. The transamination reaction that is catalyzed by the enzyme which are called the transaminases. Now, the amino group that is present in the leucine is donated to the alpha ketoglutarate, and alpha ketoglutarate, after taking the amino acid, will form the glutamate. The significance of the formation of this glutamate will be discussed later when we talk about the glucose-alanine cycle. The removal of the amino group from the leucine will lead to the formation of the compound called alpha keto isocaproic acid. Now, this alpha keto isocaproic acid will undergo branch chain alpha keto acid dehydrogenation reaction, catalyzed by the enzyme which are called the branch chain alpha keto acid dehydrogenase. These are the similar enzymes that cause the conversion of the pyruvate into acetyl CoA by the enzyme called the pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, or the conversion of the alpha keto glutarate into succinyl CoA by the alpha keto glutarate dehydrogenase complex, and the coenzymes will also be same. Now, the alpha keto isocaproic acid is converted by the branch chain alpha keto acid dehydrogenase into a compound which is called the isovaleryl coenzyme A. This isovaleryl coenzyme A will undergo an FAD mediated. Dehydrogenation is NAD mediated. Here, the dehydrogenation is the FAD mediated. The FAD mediated dehydrogenation will lead to the formation of methyl crotonyl coenzyme A. The metabolism of the methyl crotonyl coenzyme A continues with the addition of the carbon dioxide into the compound, and it will lead to the formation of methyl glutaconyl. Glutaconyl, very difficult names. Glutaconyl coenzyme A. Now, the methyl glutaconyl coenzyme A will be converted into hydroxymethyl glutaryl coenzyme A, or you can say HMG-CoA. Now, this HMG-CoA will break down into two compounds, that ultimately into two compounds that are the acetoacetate, and in addition, it will convert into the acetyl coenzyme A. Now, let's talk about the metabolism of isoleucine. The isoleucine, just like its predecessor, will undergo transamination reaction, and it will be converted into the alpha keto acid, which is called the alpha keto beta methyl valeric acid. This alpha keto acid, now this reaction is also accompanied by the formation of the glutamate from alpha keto glutarate, of course, as I told you in the previous part. Now, the alpha keto beta methyl valeric acid will be undergoing the branched chain alpha keto acid dehydrogenation, and the resultant compound will be called the methyl butyryl coenzyme A. Now, this methyl butyryl coenzyme A will undergo FAD mediated dehydrogenation, and two compounds will be produced. The first compound that is produced is the acetyl coenzyme A. It will lead to the ketogenesis, that is the formation of ketone bodies, and the second compound that is produced is the propionyl coenzyme A. Let's talk about that here. Propionyl coenzyme A will convert into methyl malonyl coenzyme A, and this methyl malonyl coenzyme A is converted into succinyl coenzyme A. Because this is the glucogenic action, because the succinyl coenzyme A is the glucogenic compound in of the Krebs cycle. This is a B12 requiring reaction. Now let's talk about the amino acid that is left is valine. The valine amino acid will also first undergo transamination. The alpha ketoglutarate will accept the amino group and the glutamate will be formed. Now the transamination of the valine leads to the formation of alpha keto isovaleric acid. The next step, just like all others, is the branch chain alpha keto acid dehydrogenation that will lead to the formation of isobutyryl coenzyme A. The FAD linked oxidation, dehydrogenation of the isobutyryl coenzyme A, FAD linked dehydrogenation, will lead to the formation of propionyl coenzyme A. This propionyl coenzyme A will be converted into methyl malonyl coenzyme A, and this methyl malonyl coenzyme A will then be converted into succinyl coenzyme A. Now let's talk about the metabolism of the succinyl coenzyme A and the relationship of the succinyl coenzyme A with the glucose alanine cycle. The succinyl coenzyme A will enter the Krebs cycle in the cell, and it will be ultimately converted into pyruvate by the process of the Krebs cycle and the gluconeogenesis. Now this pyruvate does not have any amino group. Basically, the amino group that is denoted to the pyruvate comes from the glutamate that has been formed in the first reaction of the branch chain amino acid metabolism. The glutamate donates its methyl group to pyruvate, and in turn is converted into alpha ketoglutarate. This is reused and the cycle continues. The glutamate is produced, donates the amino group to pyruvate. Now the pyruvate is then converted into alanine. This alanine will dumped into the blood, and it will travel to the liver and contributes in the glucose alanine cycle. In the next video, we will talk about the biosynthesis of the amino acids. If you like my content, please subscribe to my channel and share with your friends. Thank you.